nothing so far has really happened. That's actually, no offense, not even day one in terms of your deep brain stimulation management or deep brain stimulation future. It's really turning the thing on and getting it dosed. And so that's what programming is, and that's what we do in the neurology department. So right up here, this is what the electrode looks like. There are four little silver cylinders you'll see on it. Those are called contacts. And so what we do, what Dr. Brodsky and I do, is we turn on one of those contacts and we turn it up. And we see what happens. We see where is that in the target where Dr. Birchall put it. And then we do the next one. And we see what happens. We look at your symptoms, how they improve. We look at what side effects we get. We might change the shape of that. And from that, we find the right stimulation parameters that work for you, for your symptoms, for that place that Dr. Birchall put it. And so we can account for your anatomy responding in a different way. So although he's put it in what he would consider the right spot, your body may respond in a different way, and so these electrodes give us the latitude to adjust for that. They also give us the latitude to adjust for the fact that this is a progressive disease. What you want today, what your body needs today, may not be what your body needs 5 years from now, and we can change the settings, change the shape, change the density of charge to account for that. What does it feel like? Do you remember your first programming session or when they've made adjustments to your programming? People tell me it's weird, is what they say.
Well, tremors went away within a few seconds.
Uh-huh. Well, I remember.
You remember. Yeah.
The doctor said, now I want you to tell me if that you feel anything unusual because, you know, that means we have to adjust something. So he was sitting there and he said, well, my hand's change that made the tingling in his hand go away that fast.
Yeah.
And then he said, okay, we need to, you know, see you walk. And he got up and walked, and his hand swung for the first time in years, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But the most amazing part was he smiled.
Yeah.
It was the first time I'd seen him smile in a very, very, very long time.
Yeah, and that is something we hear from folks, is just that comes back. It's bizarre, is what people say. There's tingling, there's pins and needles, there might be some tightening of your facial muscles, some thickness of your tongue. Everything's reversible. And what we're doing when we induce those symptoms is I'm making a little map for myself in my brain of what is happening in your brain. And I decide what's the right dose of stimulation for you. What does it feel like when you walk out? You don't. So you don't feel a little, bzz, 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 bzz. You don't hear anything. There's not the idea is that you don't know it's there. The idea is to simplify things for you.